I think the idea that I'm effective itself is quite new to me. I always thought I'm quite challenged. So, but when I started off, probably if I have to recount what I did differently from others, I never took myself very seriously. I took the entire idea of whatever I was doing as a game. So I'm just playing a game. Success and failure was outcomes, but you have to put in the best effort. And then deal with the success or failure. That allowed me to focus on what I was doing rather than worry of what will happen. Over a period of time, I realized that one of the best ways you can deliver returns is when you are not bothered about the outcome. And almost 98% of the time, what I have seen is people are so concerned or bogged down by the stage or the fear of what the outcome would be, that they do not focus on what they should. So what is in your control, focus on that. And what is not in your control, don't think about it. That's really one of the most important probably aspect of why I came this far. So if you think about a guy with 5,000 rupees in his pocket trying to have an ambition of raising money in thousands of crores and having no background in finance and yet able to raise it, one of the practices that worked was not taking myself too seriously. I actually do not ever think that things will not get done. So this positive self-reinforcement, you can call it self-belief, is another thing that I believe has played a very important role. My mind works in that fashion, that if somebody says it cannot be done, I see it as actually an invitation to take on a path rather than as why you should not do it. Probably the third thing that has worked very well is I am very open and always listening to what others say, but I rarely act on what others are asking me to act on. So I hear everybody's point of view, but I frame my own answers to my problems. Sometimes those external stimulus feedbacks shape my thought process. Sometimes they don't. I will take a fresh look and then selectively use those feedbacks. And now one will say, why would you actually take people's feedback if you're not going to use them? It helps you broaden the horizon. It suddenly brings perspectives to you that you don't have your own. But ultimately, I have to act on it. And so it must be my perspective. The idea of engaging with somebody else allows you to gain that perspective and somewhere, not consciously, but in unconsciously influence your own perspective. But at the end of it, I always end up believing this is my perspective, even if it is fairly heavily influenced by somebody else's. It gives you a pretty high level of confidence in your own actions over a period of time.